Okay, let's finish the cover up on our mini and then it will be done. I have put score tape all across the back, but I'm going to go between the pieces with some Scotch Quick Dry and around the outside edges. I inked the edges of the paper and I also inked the edges of the book with distress ink. And the score tape sometimes doesn't want to stick to the inked edges, so that's why I'm using the Scotch Quick Dry around the perimeter, just to make sure that it doesn't lift. Using a brayer over the edge just to make sure I don't have any bubbles or anything. And I'm doing the same thing here again, putting the Scotch Quick Dry between the pieces of score tape, and then laying the back down. And again, I inked heavily around the back edge. You can see the brown there. I think that's, I think it was gathered twig that I used. That's what I've used mostly in the whole book. And now I'm going to line up the front edge. I had a little mark that I made on one of the lines telling me how far I wanted it to go over the front edge. And I'm going to line that up with the front of the cover. And once I get that lined up, then it's just a matter of bringing it to the back, making sure that it's even at the top, and then pressing it down very securely so you've got that hinged area where the book is going to open and close, getting rid of any excess glue there. And now we're going to go ahead and finish the front. I have three different laces here. These are from the Piece by Piece, and I'm just trying to decide which one I like the best. They are cream, although it looks white sometimes in it, but it is a cream lace. And this is the one I've decided on. And I just want it to go over the seam. I'm going to be putting flowers and other stuff over the top of it, so some of it isn't going to show, but I want to get rid of that seam where the spine goes around to the front. I'm using Fabri-Tac on it because that stuff, with any ribbons or anything that you put down, it glues like iron. I'm not kidding. I just love it. Just trimming the edges so it's even with the book and tucking them up into the Fabri-Tac so they'll stay stuck. Now what I've done is I took the flowers from the... Oh, getting ahead of myself here. I took this bird board, and I added two pieces of chipboard behind it, the round circle part, so it would pop up around the frame. The flowers are the flowers from the collection that I made up, and then I had little roses and little flowers in my stash of stuff that I ended up using for the centers. And I'm just trying to figure out where I want to place it, and then I'm using hot glue to adhere it down. I used crystal lacquer on the top of the bird, let it dry for about 24 hours, and it's got a beautiful sheen to it now. So I'm just kind of putting my flowers down, figuring out where I want the placement, and then just playing with them. And that's basically what you do when you do the cover. You get all the things that you think you might want on it and have them handy, and then you just keep playing with it, tucking them in here and there to see what looks the best. And then when you find something that you like where it goes, then you stick it in. I also cut a bunch of the little pink flowers from the paper, and I put a layer of Mod Podge on the front and the back of all the little pink flowers that I cut. Then I took a rubber mat, and I have a, it's actually a burnishing tool for rub-ons, but it has a rounded end. So I curved all of my little flowers, and like I said, I Mod Podged them, and I don't know, I have quite a few of those because I just wanted those little individual flowers to go over the ones that are on the paper that's glued to the front. It just gives a lot more dimension, and with the Mod Podge on them, they'll have quite a bit of stability. I'm adding some of these gemstone things here, floral spray, and I can't remember what the other one's called. They're also from the Piece by Piece. And I'm just tucking them in. That's one of the single leaves there that are flowers that I'm tucking in and around, trying to get the proportions of what I like here and there. I do have these flowers that I'm putting on right now. That was a long, a large swag that I had bought. It was a springtime swag, and I got it about Christmas time at 90% off. And I just took it completely apart, took all the flowers off, and put them in a big Ziploc bag. And every once in a while, they're just perfect for what I'm doing. I had rolled that end of that the little bead things there, the wheat spray that I put in, and rolled it around my paintbrush. I think you saw me do that, but I ended up not liking it, so I clipped that off. This is it. You just keep playing until you get the look you like. This is another little oh, I wish I could remember the name of them. I don't have them right here in front of me. But that was the only pink one of that little flower spray I like, but I like the way it sits up. And with the hot glue, you can glue it in and then it stays wherever you put it. I was gonna put those sparklets from KaiserCraft in, but they just didn't look right. Now I found these little off cream colored half pearls, or flatbacks, and I'm going to put them in the middle of all of the raised little individual flowers that I made. I put them on the ones that were on the actual book that aren't raised up, right on the paper, but I took them back off again. I didn't like the look of them. And what I had was some pink KaiserCraft dewdrops, and they're clear. They feel like jelly almost. And I put those over the top of my the flowers that are right on the paper on the book, the ones that are the whole flower that had the center. And that just, you don't notice them until you move the book, and then you see the sheen. They're really kind of neat. I've not used those dewdrops before. But there's the book, all finished. I'll do some still photos and add them. Thanks a bunch for joining me on this series. Bye bye now.